apparently taking a strong stance and invoking the notwithstanding clause and declaring a strike illegal, that has all gone by the wayside in a matter of just 72 hours. It's not on brand anymore, as Doug Ford would say. And you know, when it comes to being on brand, I think we have seen with the passage of these last few days what brand Doug Ford represents. That's right, Doug. Stick this in your cherry cheesecake. David Menzies for Rebel News here at Queen's Park in Toronto. And so it is that the government's war with CUPE, the Canadian Union of Public Employees, ends not with a bang, but with a whimper. You see, folks, on Monday, Doug Ford, well, he bent the knee.
You know, folks, I don't want to fight. I just want the kids in school. That's what I want to do. You know, I'm past the stage of fighting, and it's not worth it. People don't want it. Parents don't want it.
We thought when he invoked the notwithstanding clause, this was going to be Doug Ford's 1981 Ronald Reagan moment. You remember back in 81, Ronald Reagan told more than 11,000 air traffic controllers that if you don't get back to work from your strike, you're fired.
We cannot compare labor management relations in the private sector with government. Government cannot close down the assembly line. It has to provide without interruption the protective services which are government's reason for being. It was in recognition of this that the Congress passed a law forbidding strikes by government employees against the public safety. Let me read the solemn oath taken by each of these employees and the sworn affidavit when they accepted their jobs. I am not participating in any strike against the government of the United States or any agency thereof, and I will not so participate while an employee of the government of the United States or any agency thereof. It is for this reason that I must tell those who fail to report for duty this morning, they are in violation of the law, and if they do not report for work within 48 hours, they have forfeited their jobs and will be terminated.
Well, they thought Reagan was bluffing. He wasn't. He fired them. And sure, for that summer, there was all kinds of delays at airports, but eventually new air traffic controllers were hired. But imagine that from the moment the notwithstanding clause was invoked on Friday, something changed by Monday. And on Monday, that's when Ford announced he didn't want to fight anymore. Those were his words, folks, that he was bending the knee, that he wanted CUPE to end their strike, and in return the government would revoke the notwithstanding clause. And it's an outrage, because who speaks for Ontarians? And by the way, just take a look at the people that Doug Ford is acquiescing to. Cameraman Lincoln Jay and I came to Queen's Park on Friday when there was a big illegal strike on the grounds. Just check out some of the comments those CUPE scholars had to say.
Why do you say that? Why do you say that?
Because you're a bunch of right wing trolls.
Hi, sir. I'm just trying to make sense of your side. Oh, really? You don't talk to fascists? Who would the fascists be here?
You, Rebel News. Okay.
CUPE, that's the plant-eating dinosaur, right?
Yeah. You know they're far right.
Oh, what does far right mean, sir?
It's all, but turn the map upside down, and which way is up?
Okay, just letting you know.
There's been an intervention by Mr. Dress-Up. Your sign here. What is eco-socialism?
To your scab reactionary fascistic media. So get lost.
How am I a scab by doing journalism on the lawns of Queen's Park, sir?
Yeah. That's it. We're done.
Hey, how's it going? I said
Oh, that's not very ladylike.
Talk to this guy.
Oh, yeah, well.
You can have nothing. Go away.
Well, that's not very communist of you. I thought it's all about sharing the wealth.
Just go away.
Okay, then. Can you say sentence without using profanity?
About.
Yeah, you right-wing ass.
I don't think he understood the question.
Yeah, I did.
Are you
you?
You.
Why? Why are you like that?
You.
I'm angry.
Excellent.
Yeah, so in my book, that might have been the greatest advertisement for homeschooling ever broadcast. And yet, here we are, just 72 hours later, and Doug Ford has called it quits. So what was it? Was it public perception, perhaps? Was he getting some blowback? And that made him quit the war against QP? Or do you think, folks, it was his new best boyfriend, I'm talking Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, who Doug Ford stands shoulder to shoulder with? Was it Doug Ford, was it rather Prime Minister Trudeau? Yeah, I know, it's hard to tell them apart these days. Was it Prime Minister Trudeau admonishing Doug Ford for invoking the notwithstanding clause, even though, of course, the Prime Minister invoked his heaviest hammer in the toolbox, that being the Emergencies Act back in February when it came to dismantling the Freedom Convoy? I think it is. I think Doug Ford thrives on getting the approval of his new best friend, and that is what made him revoke the notwithstanding clause. And when asked in a press conference how the strike was going to get resolved, because QP still want more pay, of course, and it's always for the kids, mind you, Doug Ford said he wasn't privy to give that information. Imagine if the province was a publicly traded corporation, folks, and there was some crisis. Could you imagine the board of directors telling its shareholders, no, we can't tell you anything about what's going on behind the scenes. That's private. No, it's not. This is a public issue. It's a public union. These are public schools. The Ford PCs should be transparent. But apparently taking a strong stance and invoking the notwithstanding clause and declaring a strike illegal, that has all gone by the wayside in a matter of just 72 hours. It's not on brand anymore, as Doug Ford would say. And you know, when it comes to being on brand, I think we have seen with the passage of these last few days what brand Doug Ford represents. That's right, Doug. Stick this in your cherry cheesecake. For Rebel News, I'm David the Menzoid Menzies. Hey folks, I know you love it when Rebel News brings you the other side of the story, but it comes at a cost. We don't receive a single nickel of government funding from this Trudeau regime, nor would we accept it if offered. So if you can, please go to rebelinvestigates.com. That's rebelinvestigates.com. And if you're able to, kindly make a donation. My thanks in advance.